Hello students, today we are going to discuss some questions based on Young's double slit experiment, and all these questions are previous year IEC questions. So I'll start with question for the year 2007. Okay, let's see what we have. I have skipped some years in between because some of the questions are actually common. So I just touched the questions which are of different types. Okay. So I'll start with the year 2007. So this is year 2007. This question, and the question will appear on your screen now, and you can just pause the video and you can read the question. The question says that the distance between the first and the sixth bright fringe formed in Young's double slit experiment is found to be 12.5 mm. So remember, when we do the setup and when we see the fringes, then this is my first fringe, the central bright maxima, then you have dark, and then you have bright again, then you have second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Okay, don't worry about the spacings. So the question says the distance between the first and the sixth bright fringe. So the first, second, this, remember, this is not counted as first, this is the central zero order. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So the distance between the sixth and the first is given to you as 12.5 mm. So how do you put that in the equation? We can put that in the equation by using this expression. Now we know that this is y for the first bright fringe, and this is y for the sixth bright fringe. And the value of y6 minus y1 is equal to 12.5 mm as per the question. Correct? Now what is 6? Do you remember the formula? Do you remember the formula? Y is equal to n lambda d by d. So for y6, the value of n is 6. And for y1, the value of n is 1. So when I'm going to put this in the formulas, I will write here as 6 lambda d by small d minus 1 lambda d by small d, or just lambda, or you can say 1. Okay, and that is equal to 12.5 mm. I can write as 10 power minus 3 meter, and this gives you 5 lambda d by d. So this gives you 5 lambda d by d equals to 12.5 into 10 power minus 3 meter. Now let's read the question further. The first question says find the fringe width. Okay, first question is find the fringe width. Now remember, the value of fringe width, the value of lambda is lambda d by small d. Okay, so I have over here the expression with 5. So I can say that lambda d by small d is equal to 12.5 into 10 power minus 3 divided by, and this 5 comes down over here. And then this will be 5, and this is nothing but exactly the value of fringe width. So we got the value of fringe width, which will be equal to this. And remember the order. Order is in terms of meters. Okay. Now the question further says that if, let us say if slit is, if the separation between the slit is 0.12 mm, so you have 0.12 mm as the value of d. And the distance between the spring and the slit is 60 cm, that is capital D is equal to 60 cm. So we are going to convert this first into meter. So into 10 power minus 3 millimeter, and this will be equal to 60 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Okay. So we have this together. Find the value of wavelength, and you have to find the value of wavelength in nanometer. Okay. So what we will do? So if we use this expression over here, lambda d by small d and all. So from this expression I can say that lambda is equal to 12, okay, you have to calculate this, okay, since we have not done the calculation, so I am just writing the same thing over here. 12.5 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 5, then small d goes and gets multiplied over here, and d gets divided over here, and this is equal to 12.5 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 5, small d. What is the value of small d? Small d is 0.12 into 10 power minus 3 divided by, and the value of capital D will be equal to 60 into 10 power minus 2 meter. This is what you will do. And then when you do the calculation, the answer which you will be getting, will be around, I guess, 5 into 10 power minus 7. I'm just teaching you how to convert this into nanometer. So you will get the answer as 5 into 10 power minus 7 meter. Now, nano means the value of nano. Nano means 10 power minus 9. Okay? So you have to convert this to 10 power minus 9. So what will you do? You will write 5 into 10 power minus 7. I need a minus 2 more, so I will multiply with minus 2 and then I will divide by minus 2. So 10 power minus 2 and this minus 10 becomes 10 power minus 9, and then this is 5 into 10 power minus 9 divided by 10 power minus 2. And then this minus 2 goes at the top, and that will become 5 into 10 power minus 9 into 10 power 2. And then this is nothing but equals to 500 nanometer. Because this is 100 multiplied by 5 becomes 500. And this term is nanometer. You could have done directly also, if you know how to shift the decimals, you can directly put this as 5 into 10 power minus 7, 2 more zeros, and it becomes nanometer right away. Okay? So that's the year 2007. Okay, now we are going for 2011. Please pause the video and take a note. This is year 2007. So please pause the video and take a note, and then we are going ahead and we will be doing year 2011. Let's start. Okay, year 2011. The question will appear in your screen right now. In YDSE, using monochromatic light L1 of wavelength 700 nanometer, 10th bright fringe was obtained at a certain point P on a screen. Which bright fringe will be obtained at the same point if the monochromatic light of the wavelength 500 nanometer is used in place of L1? Okay, so let us say this is 2000, ISE 2011. So let us say that this is my screen. Let us say this is a point P. And the distance of point P from the center point is Y. Now at Y, two things are happening at two different experiments happening. So when the first experiment was conducted, it was conducted with a wavelength of, let us say, lambda 1. So I will write like this, N1 lambda 1 d by small d. If you read the question says, when the wavelength of 10th 700 nanometer, 10th bright fringe was obtained. So when lambda 1 is 700 nanometer, which bright fringe was obtained? 10th bright fringe was obtained. And at the same position, when I used another wavelength, some other order bright fringe was obtained, the different wavelength. But the position is same, so the value of Y will remain same. So I have to find the value of N2 now with the second wavelength given to you as 500 nanometer. Correct? So now let's put the value here in the data. So you will have N1 lambda 1 divided by capital D by small d equals to N2 lambda 2 capital D by small d. Okay, these two will get cancelled out. So you have to find the value of N2. N2 will be N1 lambda 1 divided by lambda 2. And that is equal to N1. N1 is 10. Lambda 1 is 700 nanometer divided by 500 nanometer. Nanometer goes out. 0000 goes out. That becomes 70. This becomes 2. 7 2s are 14. So the value of N2 is 14. That means 14th order bright fringe will be obtained when you use a wavelength of 500 nanometer. Here the question is done. Okay, the answer is 40, is all over. But I just wanted you to understand this question. Just imagine this experiment is done simultaneously. Simultaneously, two waves are being used. And that's a very important thing. Simultaneously, two waves are being used. So if you use two waves together, what will you find? You will find that there will be points on the screen where the bright fringes will overlap. That means, just now in this question we saw that at this particular point, the 10th order of 700 nanometer light and the 14th fringe of 500 nanometer light are meeting at the same point. So you will definitely find many other points where the value of y will be same for the bright fringes, though of not the same order, of different order, like here 10 and 14. But definitely there will be points on the screen where the bright fringes of two different colors will overlap. And at those points you are going to get some hybrid colors, correct? So that is also a very good concept, you should keep that in mind. Also at the center point on the screen, because remember for n equal to 0 and n equal to 0. For this n equal to 0 and for this n equal to 0, for both being 0, 0, the value of y is 0. That means central point will be the 0 order fringe for both the color of light. So even at the center point, you are going to get a hybrid color, not the color corresponding to 700, not the color corresponding to 500. It will give you a hybrid color over there. That means the fringes are getting overlapped over there. So that just keep that in mind. So in that note, what do you think will happen if you use a white light in Young's double slit experiment? And let us say it's a coherent source of light. Because coherent never said that it's the main criteria of coherent source is that it should have a constant phase difference. So if I use a white light over here, what we are going to expect? We are going to, what will be the color of the central bright fringe? So if you use a white light, just imagine if you are using a white light. Okay, I'll just rub this and I will take you to some other concept right now. So what will happen if you use a white light? Okay, so if you use a white light, this is one more question. Let us try to understand this formula again, y is equal to n lambda d by small d. Remember, there is a lambda here and there is an n over here. But whatever be the value of lambda, the moment you put n equal to 0, the y becomes 0. That means for all colors, even if you use here, Vibhor over here on this side, it means the white line, the central bright fringe will be a white color bright fringe. It will be a white color bright fringe. Because for all lambdas, the moment you put n equal to 0, y is 0. For whatever value of lambda you put, the moment you put n equal to 0, y is 0. So the 0 order bright fringe will be white in color. And then who comes first? Who comes first? For n equals to 1, if I have to put n equals to 1, then lambda and then d by small d. For whom the value of y will be least? The value of y will be least for that color whose lambda is least. And we know in deep pure violet has the least color. So the next bright fringe, the first order bright fringe will be formed of violet. Then the first order bright fringe will be formed because of Vibhor. Then the first order bright fringe will be formed because of blue. And then you are going to get a pattern of spectrum of Vibhor on either side. On either side. So Vibhor on this side and Vibhor on this side. Both. Okay? This is R. Okay, so don't forget this. If they ask you for once answer reflected question, what happens when you use a white light? Answer is the central bright fringe will be white in color. Along with that, there will be a spectrum of there will be a color spectrum of seven colors starting from Vibhor, and as you go up, it will go to red. Or just draw this diagram in your own way, and definitely you will get the full marks. Okay? Okay, I will go to the next question. The next question here is for the year 2014. Let's see what is there in the year 2014. In Young's, and the question will appear on your screen right now. In Young's double slit experiment using monochromatic light, fringes are obtained on a screen placed at some distance from the slits. If the screen is moved by 5 × 10⁻²⁰ towards the slit, the change in the fringe width, it is moved by, okay. So whatever this, let us say this is your slit, this is your screen. The question says, and this is the formula for beta. Beta is equal to lambda, lambda d by small d. Okay, so the question says that the screen is moved by, so let us say the screen is moved by 5 into 10 power minus 2 meter towards the slits, the change in the fringe width is 3 into 10 power minus 5 meter. So the fringe width changes. Now what do you expect? D is directly proportional. If D is directly proportional, you are decreasing the capital D. If you decrease the capital D, your beta will decrease. So initially if I said my bright fringe was having a thickness of this much, now I will have a thickness of lesser than the previous one. So there is a change here in the thickness. And that change in the thickness is given to you as 3 into 10 power minus 3. 3 into 10 power minus 3 meter. 3 into 10 power minus 5 meter. If the distance between the two slit is 10 power minus 3 meter, if the distance between the two slit is 10 power minus 3 meter, 10 power minus 3 meter, find the value of wavelength used. So I am going to use a very tricky way of doing this question. Now this is beta equal to lambda d by d. Lambda is not changing, small d is not changing. So if I use this formula, and if I do the change over here, delta beta will be equal to lambda into d into multiplied by. So the change is happening because of the change in capital D. And what is the change? Change is equal to 3 into 10 power minus 5 equals to lambda. Lambda I have to find out. Small d is 10 power minus 3. And delta D is 5 into 10 power minus 2. And that will give you the value of lambda. Please calculate lambda from here and the answer will be in terms of meter. Then we will go for year 2050. Take a note here. Year 2050. Laser light of wavelength 630 nanometer is incident on a pair of slits which are separated by 1.8 mm. If the screen is kept 80 cm away from the two slits, calculate. Now this is 2015, was a direct questions. Okay, direct questions. Like just like formula based. So it's lucky here again. So this distance is given to you is 1.8 mm. And 1.8 mm you can write as 1.8 into 10 power minus 3 meter. And the wavelength, the color wavelength, the wavelength of the light uses 630 nanometer, that is equal to 630 into 10 power minus 9 meter. And the screen is kept at a distance of 80 centimeter, that is 80 into 10 power minus 2 meter. Okay. First question, fringe separation, that is the fringe width, direct question. So the first question is fringe width, lambda d by small d. You can do it now, just put the data, all data is kept over here. And then the second question is the distance of 10th bright fringe from the center of the interference pattern. Distance of the 10th bright fringe, that is n lambda d by small d. So what is the value of n you are going to put? The value of n which you are going to put is 10 into lambda into d by small d. So lambda is given to you, capital D is given to you, this is your capital D. This is your capital D and this is your small d. Okay, this you have to put over here, use the calculator and definitely you will get the answer. Question, year 2016, nothing will appear on your screen, don't worry, I remember the question. In 2016, this year they asked to derive the expression of fringe width for 4 marks. 2016. Year 2019, derive the expression of beta equals to lambda capital D by small d. 5 marks. Whenever it is asked for 4 marks or 5 marks, listen to me very carefully, you have to start with the diagram, the derivation which you have to derive. So you will draw a diagram, you know, you will take this thing, you will take this theta. If you have seen the previous lecture, definitely you can do that. Okay? You take arbitrary point and then you will first derive the expression for y. Remember that expression of y? So you derive the expression for y and then between two bright there is a dark, or that concept you can use to derive the value of fringe width. I have discussed in detail in the previous video. So remember the year 2016 and 2019 was the year in which numerical was not asked, and what they asked was a theory question, a derivation question. Okay. And if you go to the examiner's comment, you will find that they have written that in the examiner's comment that many students just wrote the formula or many students just started from the halfway. Whenever it is asked for 4 to 5 marks, you have to start from the diagram, derive y and then derive beta. Okay, year 2000. I forgot to mention over here. This one which I just discussed was the year 2015, then the theory question. And now we are moving ahead for the year 2017. So in the year 2017, the question which was asked, which will appear on your screen right now. In Young's double slit experiment using monochromatic light of wavelength 600 nanometer, few bright rays is at a distance of 0.48 millimeter from the center of the pattern. If the screen has a distance of 80 centimeter from the plane of the two slits, calculate the distance between the two slits and the fringe width, that is the fringe separation. So again, a direct question they have asked. Let us see. Let us run through the data what they have given to you. What they have given to you is the fifth white bright fringe. N equals to 5. They have given the value of y. And how much is the value of y? The value of y is 0.48 mm. And this is n equal to 5. And the color of, and the wavelength is given also, that is your 600 nanometer, which I can write as 600 into 10 power minus 9 meter. This you can write as 0.48 into 10 power minus 3. Okay? Meter. Sorry? Yeah. Okay, and if the screen is a distance of 80 centimeter, screen distance is 80 centimeter, that is the value of capital D, which you can write as 80 into 10 power minus 2 meter. So you have to find the value of small d. So which formula you will use? You will use the formula y is equal to n lambda d by small d, and that is equal to 5 into lambda into d by small d, and so small d will be equal to 5 into lambda into capital D divided by y. So you put the value of wavelength, you put the value of capital D, you put the value of y and the value of small d. Once you have found the value of small d, that is the first part of the question. Second part of the question says find the fringe width, the fringe separation, and you know the formula. By the time you have now, by this time you have found the value of small d, so that small d will appear here with capital D and lambda, and definitely you can find the value of beta also. Year 2000, take a note, this is year 2017. Then, year 2018, it is a graph question. It was a graph question which says, in Young's double slit experiment, show graphically how intensity of light varies with distance. So, the next question is, now I thought of not picking up this question, but then something struck my mind and then I am discussing this question with you. Year 2018, in Young's double slit experiment, show graphically how intensity of light varies with distance. Distance, correct? We know with respect to phase difference, we know with respect to path difference, but what is distance? So, just we will plot, because we know only one graph in the experiment, and this is your graph. Just write here distance. Though it is not an appropriate word, it can be a deviation also, but I strongly suggest this is not an appropriate word. It should have been phase difference or path difference. And just write there as distance. Remember, there should be no sharp endings over here. Okay, and this all should be at the same height. Okay, and then we are done with this. Okay, so that's 2018, and as I told you, 2019 was the year which they asked again. So 2016 or 2019 was the year in which they asked a theoretical question. So with this, I complete my lecture. And please take a good note. Okay, and I will see you again in the next class. Thank you for watching.